My Savior, ever near to guide me. I am safe, whatever may betide me. From the storms and tempest, he will hide me in the hollow of his hand. In the hollow of his hand. I am safe, whatever may abide me, in the hollow of his hand. In his arm of love, he doth enfold me. What of peace is what never has told me. I am safe, for God himself doth hold me in the hollow of his hand. In the hollow of his hand. In the hollow of his hand. I am safe, whatever may be by me. In the hollow of his hand. I want to welcome all of us in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ for the short message, brief message indeed, that the message that will teach us how to stand and fight and resist whatever that has stand before us until we conquer those forces. So therefore, you are welcome in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ once again in channel the truth of the matter by Joseph Chetuya, and I pleading with you as you watch, subscribe, share it, turn up, leave comment, and press the bell so that anytime it will be a first or number one to receive our new update. God bless you as you do so, as you follow. I want us to pay attention because it's the word of God which reveal all secrets and pull down every barrier of the life that have stand to resist our life or our joy. By the grace of God, God have been faithful and doing wonder unto us. And I know he will do it again in Jesus' name. For that we take the message that say topic, the battle motivational. The battle motivational. Now we run the message. One, do not fear, God say unto his. I will strengthen you. God say we strengthen you. God say we strengthen me. We find it in Isaiah chapter 10, Isaiah 41 verses 10, excuse. Thou, he said, for I am with thee, be not dismayed. That is the God promise. So you can see the Lord God promise. Once you get idea, once you get understand what we are saying, definitely victory is on your side, whatever matter that may face you. So important is get understand what we are saying. And next thing is work on it. Praise the Lord. Now, two, we move. And you will, that's God speaking again. He said, you and I, which is God's children. You and I, we are God's children. You know, I illustrated it the other day. Whether you believe or you didn't believe that you are a child of God or that God created the world, it doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make any meaning that God created heaven and earth. Just like you will get offended with your mother and they start announcing that your mother is no more, she is no more your mother anymore. But it doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make any meaning that you disown your mother because maybe because she is winch or whatever evil and he said, now this woman cannot continue to be my mother, doesn't make any meaning. The truth of all things, the truth of the everything and truth of the matter is that she remained your mother. Praise the Lord. Just like that, to say that God created, or God didn't create ever, or God didn't create a man, or God didn't create us. You know, Bible say that whoever that say there is no God is dead already, is a dead woman, is a dead man, although he's still living, but he have already passed away. So we consider it in that manner. So get understand of word of God, and you will pursue and get your need. Now, we move again. He said, water must give way. Every water must give way. Or every water in your world, and every water that stands before you, every water that have to, every water is indeed, may they may turn as a blood, but it doesn't matter for you, because it turning as the blood for your enemy, even as it was in the land of Egypt, the land of bondage, the waters, the rivers that in the sea turned to blood, and the all the land was filled of the lice and frog. This is what the enemy is, a portion of the enemy. So it's not for you and I that water turned to blood. Water turned to blood for the enemy. But one thing that you must know, that the enemy that you have this year, by the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, he will not cross over next year with those enemies. Go and mark it. All I pleading with you, believe God. There we find it in Exodus chapter 7:17. You can see what the Bible say there. Exodus chapter 7, verse 17. So we should not jump all. Let us just take a look of this as we proceed. And now, what is the Bible say there? Exodus 7:17. He said, thus said the Lord, in this thou shalt know that I am the Lord. Behold, I will smite with the rod that is in my hand upon the waters which are in the rivers, and they shall be turned to blood. This is a promise, and he know that God make Moses to be a God before the sight of Pharaoh. Praise the Lord. So therefore, you need to understand what we are saying all about, so that you can be able to fight a battle. So what we're saying, that no matter whatever that may face or stand before you today, the answer and the way out of this is the word of God. As you stand on the word of God and follow the word of God bumper to bumper, before you know it, your life will reshadow for the glory of God and reshape for the power of God. That is what is when someone follow the word of God. God will start rebuilding you. God will start recoupling you new again, until he bring you to the perfection that which he need you to be. And Moses said unto the people, fear ye not, stand still that I say unto you. Now I myself I say, know that Moses said to the people, but now I myself I saying unto you, fear not. That we find it in Exodus 14:13. He said, the Lord shall fight. The Lord, I want to announce to you, the Lord shall fight your battle. The Lord shall fight against your enemies. Only believe. We move. God is the pillar of the fire, pillar of the cloud, by day and by night to his people. God will be the pillar of the cloud in the day for you, the cloud of the fire in the night for you, so that he will keep you moving. This is the presence of God before the children of Israel. So therefore, whatever problem or whatever need or whatever obstacle that is stand before you, just remember that you have one that who stand by side, which is God, is the pillar by night and pillar by day, which will keep you moving. Praise the Lord. As you believe it, it will find it come to pass. Jesus said, "For I am with you always, even unto the end of the world, even unto the end of the earth, even unto the earth of everything." Jesus is with you. Now imagine if Jesus is with you. Then why should you think that situation and condition have taken over you? Why do you think there's no more way out? That the smile have disappeared? That the smile has vanished away? That there is no joy? That you will just die like that or pass away? That is not true. Jesus, whom we talk, Jesus, whom we speak about, He loves you right when you was in your mother's womb. When I was in my mother's womb, Jesus loves us. The Bible says He gave His life for you and I. So what is that situation? Is this sickness stand today and speaking? And when you see the volume of the sickness, there is no more hope. It is not true. Devil is that administer to you that there is no more hope. Devil is that are using the doctors and nurses and telling you there is no more hope. Believe the Bible, believe the word of God, you will see hope sprinkle out again. You will see hope flow again. Praise the Lord. For all the promises of God in Him are yea, and in Him, amen. You see, Jesus loves you. That is a promise of God. And His word is yea and amen. That is what He told us. Now, remember that Psalm 34 says, "The angel of the Lord encamped around about them that fear Him." Around, angel of the Lord will camp around you, about you, if you fear God. And that when the angel of the Lord encamp about you, why did He camp about you? Is to fight your battle. Remember that He tell Joshua, "As the captain of hosts, I come." As a captain of hosts, the Lord God come to fight your battle. The Lord God come to stand to show that indeed He's the one that call you. In Isaiah chapter 62, says verse 1, I say, "For Zion's sake will I not hold my peace." Mean that God will say that He will not hold up His peace because of you. We are not talking about the Zion of the old, we are talking of you. Remember the Bible said that who shall return, return for your learning. So therefore, when you believe it, it will work for you. So therefore, the Zion say there that He talk, that He is saying, the Bible saying, is you, and then that fear the Lord. So you need to believe God. You need to fear God. You need to hold His word. And as you hold His word, He will change everything around you. He say now that the God will not have peace because He say I for your sake. God say He cannot have peace. He cannot give peace because of you and I. God saying it. He cannot give up for Zion's sake. So you are the Zion. And whatever that cometh on your way, on our way, God know it and already make a way for that. Whatever trouble, whatever need, whatever solution that come before you, before God is not unsuddenly, before those things come to be, God already make a way for you. God already prepare a way out for that. You may not know it. I may not know it. You may be crying, but those things are already take care of. That is God. Because the Bible say in James, remember the Bible say that God can never give you that which is above you to carry. So therefore, mean that whatever that come before you, God already make way out. Praise the Lord. How long will thou forget? Will thou forget ever? How long will thou hide thy face, O Lord? O God. This is a question that psalmist has in God, which is our father David. He asking God, how long shall you just forget Him? Shall you just forget Him forever? But God can never. Remember the Bible says, in Isaiah that the Zion said that the Lord are forsaken him, but God cannot forsake him. Can mother forsake his sucking child that he have been? He said, yeah, they may forget, but I, God, will not forget. So you need to know that there is no way that he have been a desire of God that you will born sorrow or suffer sorrow until the last day. It's never been the will of God. And it can never be the will of our Lord Jesus Christ. The enemy had done it, and also our ignorance also compose them all and bring them together to seem like it's true. But it is the work of Satan. So God can never forget anyone. Praise the Lord. Of course, you know that Bible said, Jesus said, for the sinner's sake, he come. He come not for the righteous, but he's for the sinner he come. So then how then thinking you that God have forget you? God didn't forget you. Those ideas proceed for the pit of hell. Is Psalm 13 verses 1, he get it there. Now, I want you to know why we say this. Remember our topic, the battle motivational. The battle motivational, because I want to show you the spiritual that motivates you to battle, that you will not give up until you have your victory, until you come out. Because any child of God that know the Bible, know the word of God, are bound and the men to overcome his enemy or to come whatever that come or before him or before her. Whatever situation, when he give that situation the word of God proper as it's supposed to be, you must conquer that situation. I tell you true, I am a living testimony, and I know that many of us is a living testimony of this. All we have and all that disturb us and all that make us to cry is just ignorance. It's just ignorance to know whom we are. Sometimes we didn't know who we are in a Christ Jesus. Sometimes we base upon man or upon woman that is praying for you. But that prayer that is praying for you, what you pray is more value before God. Because God wants you to sacrifice. God wants you to show appreciation. You know, today you can see some people that are even paying prophet for prayer. I tell you, that is what we're hearing on this earth. Men send money, men, women give money to prophet, and you go and do all kind of evil, and prophet will pray him for you. Oh, how shame, how shame, how useless generation that man we have found ourselves into. So therefore, get understand, and the truth will mend you free. Now remember, 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verses 3 and 4, is to tell you, because this evening I didn't call you that say that you must be holy and righteous. But I'm always tell you, holiness and righteousness that take you to heaven to be with our Lord Jesus Christ. But to come out of your problem, come out of your need, you must put your knees down and fight the battle and say to the Lord, I cannot continue be messed up of this situation, or no having document, or marry and no having child, or age of marry and no having husband, well, or no having wife, or having document, no job, or your health, or all the hospital around your city have known you. They have sent you here and there for tests, for or whatever. But it seems like all going worse because we didn't know who we are in God. When you know who you are, you can create another organ in you. I tell you, it can create another situation in your life. You can create job. You can create joy. It can create happiness in your life. You can create husband and wife, because the word of God makes us understand in Genesis. He said that Lord himself is that that make a man. And after man, God find a man have no help missing. So therefore, he make a helping meet for him, which is a wife to him. Now, how then that Lord himself is that or them marriage right from the Garden of Eden? So then how then that you would reach the age of marriage? You know, marry, and maybe then they're telling you there is a person that doing your family doesn't marry in time, or they doesn't marry at all. And so therefore, when you are clocking 25, 30, you are panicking. But I want to tell you where there is solution. Solution is the word of God. Solution is give yourself to God. Solution is to stand and say, I will never let you go. And they are going to show you people that do it. Why? Listen. So this night, it depends the time you receive the message, or the morning or afternoon is the time that you receive it. But I want to say, in that moment you receive the message, if you follow this message, and if you get just understanding, just little eye opening on this message, you will overcome those things that have been overcoming you all this while. Praise the Lord. Now see where your power and my power and our trust is. The day of reparation, holiness are coming. But this night is to you to possess your possession. The Bible says that since the death of John the Baptist, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and is only the fallen people take it by force. You will take your health by force. You will take your joy by force. Because they start from there, you give your life to Christ. You and make yourself enemy before God. Because we, Bible say that all are sin and come to the church of glory of God. What does it mean? So therefore mean that we all from sin, and we are all sinner through the Adam and Eve. Because we are the descendant of Adam. So you must know it. So therefore mean that that time that you are not yet surrender yourself to God, he walk into your father Satan. So the day you determine to follow Jesus means that you're denouncing him. So definitely he will come after you. Definitely he will do all to bring you back. But if you didn't get to understand, he will bring you back. But if you get to understand, he will use the word of the Lord Jesus. Man shall not live by bread alone. Man shall not live by meat alone. That it is written, only God, our God, a man shall bow to. So therefore, they finally will tell Satan, get out and get thee beside, and get thee out of me. And devil will get out when he speak it with authoritative, with the power of the Holy Spirit, with the power of understanding of the Spirit of God. Praise the Lord. Remember, the channel when you are listening is the channel of truth of the matter. We are bringing you the message from Bible. We are not coming to tell you our mind, and we tell you what to do. Sometimes you follow big men of God that want to preach so that you will come and give offering or pay tithe, or because they will come and give one donation in order. They may preach you righteousness, holiness. But those holiness didn't come from the mind of God. Those holiness come because they have things they're targeting. Those things come because he have things they need of you. And when they preach you holiness, he will think that he's Jesus Christ. But Jesus doesn't honor their word. Why you know that Jesus doesn't honor their word? After that, when they pray prayer, how the church is? How the people that in that church is? We are man of God that have prayed prayer. Because that prayer doesn't move anywhere. Because he have a target. That target, how to buy jet, how that target, how to buy latest car, how that target, how to take your money and building his own house, and still yet telling you that he's not covetousness. But why you know who is covetousness? When the person talking, his character, no matter how the person repent, any person that born covetousness, a hardly, them may use gospel, use the word of God, bring everything down. But indeed, the G of that is, you will see that all things he pursuing, when you open your eyes to look, whether if he pursuing thing of church, is the only thing of church, he hardly he take care of his member. And whenever a member fall into problem or into need, he will find anywhere to make you to understand that that person is not full member, because he don't want to bring out that which he have already taken for you. He just like Satan. Satan collect, but not to bring out. Still yet, this person will preach you holiness and righteousness. So be careful who you follow. Be careful who you are listening. Praise God. So therefore, I bring you the word of God. And I want to tell you that that which he hoping who God, so man of God, to do for you, is already for you. You can do it by yourself. But for Jesus, I have pulled down that word of the partition. Jesus have tear it that you can be able to enter. You can be able to intercede. So therefore, it is not time to call a pastor, call whoever that you are dying, you had a dream, and the person will use you, make a caricature up. He will tell you that he praying, maybe where as he finished making that noise, he went to his bed and his table and start eating semo, stay eating whatever he eating. And when he remember that this sister coming, he will just do some casual thing, go and, because he's not interested. What interested is money that he will bring, he will use buy his car. What interested is money he will use to populate the church, get church here. But those church that he getting, do you think that he getting it because he want to souls of men to go heaven? It's because he find out that whether it's €1, 50 cents you giving. When he bring this and bring this, he make a big money. Is your money targeting? There are few in number that meant to carry the souls of men and women to heaven. So that is why I always call them poor people, poor preacher. Not but some people think that he's poor because like I receiving, how do you say poor, this one is riding jet, this person doing this. But what I call them poor because devil himself is poor and they are agent of devil, no matter with their good speech. So therefore, be careful. Now, I read you this final. He said, for 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verses 3 and 4, say, for though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of stronghold. That is word of God. So you can see. You can see. So where I read to you this evening is not a message. Where I read this is not a message to tell you repent now so that you will not go heaven. You will not go hellfire. It is message to tell you have right to set yourself free. You have right to give mandate when their problem will finish. When that your need. When the spirit of barrenness will get. You have right. I'm no hassle whether I have right. I tell that you have right. Because God said, be fruitful, multiply and replenish the earth. It's the word of God. But if you didn't get to understand, devil will bring the idea that you are barren, put on your head, put on your mind, and doctor will help to scatter everything. Doctor will tell you that he cannot make it at all. You just forget about this and that. But I want to tell you, it's not true. There is no way the Lord God wants you to sorrow. There is no way the Lord God wants us to suffer. It's not the will of God. It's not the will of God. No matter what some preacher will tell you. And like I said the other time, some preacher in their church, they have never seen any person that is holy. When he wants to find people who is holy, it's him and the wife and the children. Because heaven is holy for them. But you cannot ask yourself why. That someone have been following one pastor for 5 years, 10 years, still yet the same pastor continue to tell that person are not able to run the message. And sometimes he will leave another thing he's doing where there is more than even, he have more than 20 pastors. He will leave other thing that he's doing, come to doing the other ones. Why are you doing it? To make sure that he will put you under the cage. To make you to believe that you are learning. So you are ever learning. You are never finished learning. You continue. Because they are, you know what they are? They are covetous pastors. They don't, if you see them, those that they are good, is those that them, those you don't know how to do, and it's through them, he will be able to eat in the church money without no alarm. So them know how the money of church going. That is so people. So there are few in number. There are few in number that are praying for your soul. So what you need to do is know Bible, know the word of God, and you cry on it, and God will change your situation. I tell us through. Now let me explain to you why I say that this night is not the night of say repent, be holy. No, there is time for that. He cannot tell blind man to repent to be holy. He cannot tell the lame man to repent to be holy. He can't tell the person that dying now repent to be holy. It's you that call yourself man of God when you come in that situation. You need to demonstrate that you are man of God. And now, the time is now. Let me show you. For faith is to set people free. You that call yourself and you that have faith, faith is to set people free. So teach holy is good. But people need to do what? Come out of their problem. People doesn't eat holy, holy. Someone dying, that person need to be healed. Somebody is blind in your church, that person need to see. That is what that is the desire of that person. No matter how we teach that person holy, that holy is for that, fun, that moment. People need to come out to you, and that will show you for the Bible. If someone didn't come out for a problem, how then think the person to be holy? One that crying that he married over 5 years, he married for 10 years, no issue. If this person now is there to be holy, all those one you see that he think they're holy, they are pretender. They are not holy for nothing. Because when one be holy, one that holy doesn't murmur. You know that Bible say that that person that have doubt is just like the sheep upon the water tossing here and there. So therefore, they may be pastor, they pretend, they may be one for pastor, they pretend, and they may carry everything of the church because of their pretending, then remain in their problem. Like Jesus Christ said, that if this one have accepted that they are blind, they are sick, by then they will see. So they pretend, and you cannot pretend where there is God. So there is time to cry out. There is time to bring yourself. There is time to say, God, this is what I need. You marry, you want a child, the child no coming. And you are there, say you carry church, yeah, this and that. And what then you can show people? And somebody that hold you captive, we continue to tell you holy. We continue to tell you.